Welcome back, guys. Today I'm going to show you how to effectively crop large TIFF file formats into smaller, more manageable ones using a powerful software called Glopper Mapper. Have you ever found yourself struggling with cropping large files? Well, stick around because I've got the perfect solution for you. Handling large files can be quite a hassle, right? The sheer size of these files can make processing and storage a real challenge. But fear not, Glopper Mapper is here to save the day. Now, let's dive into the nitty-gritty of how to use Glopper Mapper to crop oversized TIFF files. I'll walk you through a step-by-step process that will make the task quite simple. So first, we start by launching the Glopper Mapper app. Now, when the app is launched, we go to open data and we navigate to the directory of the file, in our case, the TIFF file to be reduced. We open and we can see the TIFF file is displayed here. When this is done, we further go ahead to select the create area feature, which we use to delineate or define the boundary of the area to be cropped. So we click on it and then we select the area. In this case, the area we want to crop. So we click on the corresponding corners. When this is done, we right click and there's a modifier feature info pop up. What we do here is to give the file a name. And then we come to the feature layer and we select the feature from which we want to crop for. Once that is selected, we click on OK. From the left pane, you can see the layer or the area we created has been defined. So to crop the area, we first select anywhere within the boundary we created and then a mesh is generated highlighting the area of interest. So now to crop the area of interest, we double click on the TIFF file from which you want to crop, then we go to the raster options, and the raster options we go to the cropping tab. And then we select crop to currently selected polygon, which in our case is the area we have highlighted. When this is selected, we go to apply and we OK. From here, we can see that the area of interest has been successfully cropped. And now, after being cropped, we have to be able to export it to be used in any other third-party software. So to do that, right click, layer, export, we select the file from which we have trimmed, we OK, and then we select the extension file, that is the GeoTIFF, and then we OK. When this is done, there's another pop-up option detailing the various option format from which we can export the file. When we are satisfied with all the available options, we click on OK and then we name the file. We OK to start the export process. Mind you, this usually takes time depending on the size of the area we are cropping. For the purposes of this video, we used a smaller file to be able to aid in the demonstration. After the file has been successfully imported, we go to the program files or the folder to check the file that has been cropped. So this is the demonstration of the two files. So we drag both files onto the interface. So this is the larger file format, and this is the file that was trimmed. In conclusion, Glopper Mapper is your go-to solution for cropping large files. Not only does it make it process easy and efficient, but it also makes sure that your files are neatly organized and ready for use. So next time you are faced with need on think tasks of cropping large files, remember to use Glopper Mapper. If you find this tutorial helpful, don't forget to give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to my YouTube for more useful tutorials, and hey, I'd love to hear from you. Leave a comment below sharing your experience with cropping TIFF files. Thanks for staying. Bye bye for now.